Welcome to part 1 of a two-part series entitled Venerated Mahavatar Babaji Vegetarian, Immortal Saints, Eternal Love.
All the saints since time immemorial, whether or not they incarnate on the planet in a human body or invisible, or they live forever. For example, like Babaji in the Himalayas. Whether or not they live forever in the physical body or in the invisible manifestation, they always thinking of us and wanting to help us. That's the only thing they do, helping all sentient beings. It's just that sentient beings cannot always perceive it or receive it fully because of obstruction of karma, ignorance, or all kind of false conception or thinking.
My nature is love, for it is love alone that can change this world. Mahavatar Babaji, vegetarian.
Mahavatar Babaji refers to the great spiritual being frequently appearing physically on this earth in various forms for several hundreds of years. Numerous encounters with the enlightened Babaji are famously documented in Paramhansa Yogananda's fascinating quest for divine wisdom, his life story, entitled Autobiography of a Yogi. This book has become a highly significant and universally applauded literary work. Many ascetics have asserted to a spiritual lineage springing from Babaji's divine grace, while other masters and renowned practitioners have also recounted meeting the heavenly saint as he carried out his duties assisting the spiritual evolution of all beings. In 1946, Paramhansa Yogananda first revealed the existence of the Mahavatar Babaji to the world at large. The seemingly ageless and glorious Himalayan yogi adept is perfect in wisdom, faultless in action, can materialize, then dematerialize at will, and has been actively sowing the seeds of spirituality amongst a largely unsuspecting world for countless generations, together with the Spirit of Christ. Sri Yogananda's own spiritual lineage and meditation method is traced to Babaji, his master's master, or Param Guru, Guruji Lahiri Mahashe, was directly initiated to the spiritual technique of Kriya Yoga by the Mahavatar. Sri Mahashe's principal disciple, Sri Yukteswar, had personal encounters with Babaji, which Paramhansa Yogananda recounted as his master's testimony. Paramhansa Yogananda himself was later also graced with the presence of the great immortal master. As the sleepless saint Ram Gopal Majumdar said,
"Ages shall come and go, still the deathless master, beholding the drama of the centuries, shall be present."
Mahavatar Babaji is said to be the deathless guru, being of indeterminate age, the span of his existence an enigma to most. In Autobiography of a Yogi, Sri Yogananda said,
"There is no historical reference to Babaji, no limiting facts about Babaji's family or birthplace dear to the analyst's heart have ever been discovered."
He further describes,
"The deathless guru bears no marks of age on his body. He appears to be no more than a youth of 25, fair-skinned, of medium build and height. Babaji's beautiful, strong body radiates a perceptible glow. His eyes are dark, calm, and tender. His long, lustrous hair is copper-colored."
Mahavatar Babaji's spiritual endowments allow him to sidestep the regular transient life cycles of bodily reincarnation the ongoing processes of birth, aging, death, rebirth, and so on that almost every other physical being on this planet endures. Residing in the astral region, Babaji's mastery of yogic science, acquired over many millennia of ascetic meditation practice, allows him to materialize a suitable physical vehicle at will. He can manifest a body for as long as is necessary to perform the required spiritual assistance, either to those who yearn for his divine intercession or to those in dire need. Many of Babaji's appearances, for instance, have been in the form of famous heavenly personalities. Mahavatar Babaji is in fact the leader of a team of similar beings, all residing on the astral level, sometimes materializing together as a formidable group. Several of these encounters are memorably recounted in Autobiography of a Yogi. The words of Swami Kebalananda, Sri Yogananda's beloved Sanskrit tutor, are also transcribed in Autobiography of a Yogi.
Babaji can be seen or recognized by others only when he so desires. He is known to have appeared in many slightly different forms to various devotees, sometimes with beard and mustache, and sometimes without them. His undecayable body requires no food. The master, therefore, seldom eats.
Swami Kebalananda, a Kriya initiate, also spent time with the immortal saint and recounts some of the most famous and incredible stories about Babaji. In one instance, the great Mahavatar's group were interrupted by a devotee who had climbed upon a ledge above and threatened to jump because life would be meaningless unless he was made a disciple of Babaji's. Babaji replied,
"Jump then. I cannot accept you in your present state of development."
And so the man let go and plummeted to his death. Babaji then instructed some shocked companions to retrieve the man's twisted carcass. The Mahavatar reanimated and completely healed the man's crumpled flesh before them, speaking these words to him.
"You are now ready for discipleship. You have courageously passed a difficult test. Death shall not touch you again. Now you are one of our immortal flock."
In another dramatic incident, Babaji suddenly injures a man with a burning stick from a campfire. Babaji then immediately heals the wounded man and explains that he has just altered his karma. If he hadn't acted so as cruel as it seemed, the man's fate left unimpeded would have been far worse. Mahavatar Babaji is a spiritual being who can intercede when required in order to lessen or completely nullify the karma of an individual or even a group of souls in accordance with his divine mandate of assisting in the spiritual ascension of humanity. Unlike physically born masters who have different missions on earth, Mahavatar Babaji's abilities allow him to act silently, appearing in a suitable form at the right moment when necessary. The past affinity that Mahavatar Babaji shares with certain individuals is an important aspect of his work. Babaji's spiritual bond with Lahiri Mahashe is well documented in Autobiography of a Yogi. Paramhansa Yogananda describes his ever-watchful presence throughout his life, patiently monitoring him through a mundane existence before awakening him to the truth of his real spiritual self. He arranged that his disciple-to-be would find himself wandering in the distant mountains and go to a cave in the Himalayan foothills. Mahavatar Babaji then prompted Lahiri Mahashay's past life memory as a spiritual ascetic by presenting him with his very own meditation seat from his previous incarnation. Speaking of his eternal love for his disciple, Mahavatar Babaji said this of leading him back home.
Though you lost sight of me, never did I lose sight of you. Through gloom, storm, upheaval, and light, I followed you, like a mother bird guarding her young.
The legendary anecdote continues, as Babaji blesses the humbled Lahiri Mahashay with an incredible manifestation of a glorious golden palace glittering with jewels and surrounded by beautifully manicured gardens and delightful ponds amidst the icy mountain trails. In 1991, Supreme Master Chinghai also mentioned this wonderful story of how Lahiri Mahashay received initiation into Kriya Yoga meditation from Mahavatar Babaji.
His teacher's teacher, Yogananda's teacher, 然后在那个楼台的设施的漂亮的那种高等的那个楼台的黄金的那个那个珠宝那个楼台里面才给他印心的，因为那个人前世啊也是这样跟他印心的，意思说那个约甘南达的师公啊应该在那种情况里面啊印心才成的，懂不懂师父意思？一个人而已。
Mahavatar Babaji cleared his disciples' remnant desires of many past lives, and after this marvelous experience, Lahiri Mahashay's karma was cleansed.
Vegan, shouldering the planet.
Cherished viewers, it has been a pleasure to have you with us today.